So today we will discussing about we are ready to discuss about the hock joint and fetlock joint of hand limb. So we already discussed the two joints of this limb. One was the hip joint and another was the stifle joint. So as per the anatomical configuration of the hand limb from upper part to lower part contains following bones. First was the pelvic girdle, femur, tibia fibula, tarsal, metatarsals, and digit, which contains the three phalanges. So this joint is hock joint, considered as a composite joint because their involvement of the many bones. First is tibio-tarsal articulation, means tibio, we have already completed tibia one. So tibio-tarsal articulations. Next, proximal tarsal articulation, intertarsal articulation, distal tarsal articulation, and tarsometatarsal articulation. So before starting, you have must an idea about the position of tarsal bones, how it located. So you come here. In ox, there are total five number of tarsal bones which located in between tibio fibula and metatarsal, and arranged in a three row, proximal, center, and distal row. So proximal row contain tibial tarsal, fibular tarsal. First you must know the name. Later on, we will identify the pictures. Tibial, tibia just below, fibular tarsal just adjacent on the medial aspect. In between two, below that, fused center plus four, and distal row contains first tarsal and fused second and third tarsal. So you see here in this picture, this is clear. So Rohit, this is audible for you, Rohit
Yes,
Gupta.
sir.
So what
Yes,
bone
sir.
should be this bone? Tibia, okay? Tibia,
Huh.
tibia. And this bone, first row contains fibular tarsal and tibial tarsal. So this is the fibular tarsal. This one is the fibular tarsal, and this is the tibial tarsal. So first row completed. I think as per this row, tibial and fibular tarsal. So first row completed, tibia is also completed. Next, second row say fused C plus four, central plus four tarsal. So this is the central plus four tarsal. C, this is visible. Cursor is going on this whole C plus four bone. So out of five, three bones clear: fibular tarsal, tibial tarsal, and central plus four. Distal row contains first tarsal and fused second and third. That means one, two, three. Out of one, two, three, first is separate, then second and third is fused. Second and third is fused. So you see here, this is the second and third fused, and this is the first tarsal. So out of five, we all cleared. First row, fibular tarsal, tibial tarsal, central plus four tarsal, second, third, and first. From here, one, two, three. Out of three, two are fused, one is separate. So total five bones of the tarsal bone: one, two, three, and four. Now, we have already discussed this is the composite bone. That means it contains five articulations. These five articulation, first is tibio tarsal articulation. You see, first tibio tarsal. Then come to the picture. This is tibia bone, this is the tarsal bone. Okay, so tibio tarsal means tibia attached with the tarsal. So involvement of the tibia bones and all mainly proximal row, mainly proximal row, but some ligament those comes from here and reaches up to the this skin. So involvement of the tibia bone along with the tarsal bone, this articulation is known as tibio tarsal articulation. Okay, next is proximal tarsal articulation. It indicates proximal row of the tibio tarsal bone. Proximal means in between fibula and tibial, fibular and tibial tarsal. This articulation in between fibular bone and tibia bone, that is known as proximal tarsal articulation. Next, intertarsal articulation. Intertarsal articulation means this is the central plus fourth fused tarsal. This central plus fused tarsal it comes in contact with proximal row of the tarsal as well as the distal row of tarsal. So this is the third joint, that is the intertarsal. Intertarsal, tarsal itself in contact with the proximal row as well as with the distal row. So this is the intertarsal. Next, distal tarsal articulation. This is the distal tarsal, distal row of first, second and third. First separate and second and third are fused. So this first, second and third are also is in contact with the center part, center row, as well as the bottom of this joint. So this joint is called distal tarsal articulation. And last is tarsal metatarsal articulation. It indicates this is the metatarsal bone, this is the metatarsal, you see here, metatarsal, and this metatarsal is comes in contact with the distal row of the tarsal bone and form articulation that is known as distal tarsometatarsal articulation. Tarso, tarsal, involvement of tarsal bone as well as the metatarsal. So I think this is clear. We will go through the five articulation because it is a composite joint, and this composite joint, as per their structures, as per their involvement, we have cleared their locations. We have cleared their locations. Okay, Mr. Rohit.
Yes, sir. Sir, number of intertarsal articulation ek hi rahega, sir.
Intertarsal articulation. Intertarsal articulation means central. This C plus four. We will discuss later on. First time we only identify their position, where it located, and how it attached with the other tarsal bone. So these intertarsal central rows comes in contact with the proximal row as well as the distal row. So this is called central, or this is called intertarsal articulation. Okay, distal articulation means distal row contains two bone, first tarsal and second and third. They comes in contact to each other. Regarding this, when we will study, this is known as distal tarsal articulation and tarso metatarsal, involvement of tarsal row as well as metatarsal. This one is the tarso metatarsal articulation. So I think this is clear, their position. So we have already gone through this position. Proximal row contains two tarsal, fibular and tibial. We have seen these pictures, and second row central plus fourth, and distal was first, second and third. You see the individual pictures of the tarsal bone. This is the location. This is the located in a manner. So this is the fibular tarsal. This is the fibular tarsal. This is the tibial. This is the tibial. This is the fibular. Okay. And this below that, this is a central plus fourth. This is the central plus fourth. And this area, second plus third. This is the second plus third. And this a smaller one is the first.
Sir, TVS, sir, medial side mein na hota.
Right, tibial, tibia bones actually below. So, the sir, this is tibia, na? This is tibia. So, below the tibia.
So, sir, sir, fir tibial tarsal, sir, lateral aap likhe, sir. Wo bhi to medial hi hona
chahiye. Likha hua kahan lateral medial? Kahan pe?
Upar, sir, upar.
If it is, haan, ye thoda sa mistake hua. Ye jo tibial. Alright, you are right. Ye jo fibular tarsal jo hum log dekhte hain. देखिए जानवर में जो निकला रहता हॉक ज्वाइंट जो बाहर की तरफ दिखता है, दिस इज द फ्यूलर टार्सल. ओके, एंड दिस इज द टिबियल टार्सल. सो दिस इंडिविजुअल्स यू सी, दिस इज द फ्यूलर टार्सल फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर, एंड दिस इज फ्यूलर टार्सल आल्सो, एंड दिस इज टिबियल टार्सल. दिस इज टिबियल, दिस इज टिबियल, बिकॉज दिस टिबियल टार्सल लोकेटेड जस्ट बिलो द टिबिया बोन, जस्ट बिलो द टिबिया बोन. सो नोमेनक्लेचर इज गिवन टिबियल टार्सल. ओके, you see in this case horse, this bone is tibia bone. So this is tibial tarsal, also known as talus. Another name of tibial tarsal is talus. This is the fibular tarsal, and upper part is known as tubercalcis, and this bone is also called as calcaneus bone. Calcaneus bone, this fibular tarsal. Hum jab apne pair mein dekhte hain, ab apna bhi pair hota hai, jo pair ko rakhte hain to lateral side ko jo nikla hua dekhte ho, एड़ी जो एड़ी से नीचे देख रहे हो ना, उसको ही जो निकला हुआ पार्ट है, दिस इज नेटिंग, बट दिस इज द कैल्केनियस, दिस इज द फ्यूलर पार्ट, फ्यूलर टार्सल ऑफ द ट्यूबर कैल्सिस, फ्यूलर पार्ट ऑफ द ट्यूबर कैल्सिस. एंड बिलो दैट सेंट्रल प्लस सेंट्रल टार्सल, बिकॉज द नंबर आर इन केस ऑफ द हॉर्स 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th एंड 6th. थर्ड इज सेपरेट, सेकेंड एंड फर्स्ट हेयर फ्यूज्ड. So this is the tarsal bone. We only know the position. When we will discussing in detail about the tarsal bone, when then we go through the individual bones of the each. So this is the position of tarsal bone in case of the dog. There are 6 tarsal bone, but in case of the ox, 5 tarsal bone. This is the tibia bone. This is the tibia bone, and you must aware about the malleolus bone. When we will discuss, and we have already discussed regarding the distal extremity of tibia bone. Laterally, there is a prominence that is known as lateral malleolus. Medially, there was a prominence that is known as medial malleolus. So, this malleolus also play a role in this articulation. So, this is the tibia bone. Distally, in case of dog, this is a prominent medial malleolus. And this tibia below that talus, tibial tarsal. This is the tibial tarsal. This is the fibular tarsal, central tarsal, fourth tarsal, first tarsal, second tarsal. Means distal row, first, second, third are separated. And also having an extra fourth tarsal. So total number is 6 tarsal present in case of the dog. So one by one, we will discuss regarding the each joint. So first is composite joint. It consists following tibial tarsal. So prior to a step, all 5 joints, first we'll test tibial tarsal, later on proximal tarsal, intertarsal, distal tarsal, and tarsal metatarsal. So it indicates the all articulation of the tibial tarsal is hinge tap. Hinge means you know, you see the finger of one finger is means digit or elbow joint. Hinge means extension and flexion. You put your arms, your elbow joint towards the chest. This is the flexion. When go away from the chest, that is the extension. So same here, in case of the animal, the limb or the joint of the hock joint only comes in 2 positions. One will come in the backward position towards the body, and other will go away from the body. Anterior, maybe lateral. So this comes under the hinge joint, and the action will be inside the joint will be gliding tap. Means one small joint comes or sliding over the other. So this is the gliding. And the joint of the common ligament. So this is the basic things regarding this all joint. So first we will come near the tibio-tarsal articulation. Okay. So prior to a start the structures of the joint, there are 4 important things we have already discussed. One will be the types, bone involvement, movement, and the ligament. There are only 4 things. So in tibio-tarsal, name indicate tibia and tarsal, and we have already discuss, this is the hinge tap. Hinge tap means movement only in 2 directions. Generally, one will increase the angle between bone, another will decrease the angle between, increase and decrease. So this is the hinge tap, bone involvement, tibia. Which part of the tibia? Distal extremity of tibia. And we have also discussed the distal extremity of tibia contains 2 malleolus, that is the lateral and medial malleolus. So distal extremity of tibia comes in contact with tarsal, proximal row of tarsal. So here you see distal extremity of tibia comes in contact with proximal row of tarsal. But not only proximal row of tarsal, not only proximal, all row of tarsal. कहने का तात्पर्य है कि जो ligament हैं कुछ lateral malleolus से निकलते हैं, सिर्फ proximal row को ही नहीं देते हैं, वो नीचे की तरफ ही आते हैं. इनका involvement with the help of ligament सभी bone से हो जाता है. चाहे वो proximal row का हो या distal row का. Movement we have already flexion, extension and flexion. You know, angle between 2 bones will be increased or decreased. And there are 6 common ligaments involved in this joint. Tibio-tarsal articulation, types, hinge, bone involvement. You know, if you say in between tibia and tarsal, that will be not exactly true. True, but you have to say the distal extremity of tibia, and distal extremity of tibia mainly contains malleolus. The malleolus of the distal extremity of tibia and the all row of tarsal, movement, extension and flexion. There are 6 ligament. One by one we will discuss. First is capsular ligament. We have already know when the 2 bones comes in contact to each other and forming a cap like structure, and that is surrounded by a ligament that is known as capsular ligament. So this is 2 types of the ligaments. One which is in position of the anterior side, another is in position of the posterior side. So this ligament is called anterior capsular ligament and posterior capsular ligament. So So see here is the membranous and enclose the tibial tarsal joint in front. In front, आगे की तरफ जो रहेगा उसको हम लोग बोलेंगे. In front, this is the anterior capsular ligament, and those which go to posterior side of the same bones in between distal extremity of tibia and proximal row of tarsal, that is known as posterior capsular ligament. Next is collateral. You must be aware about the collateral is the common ligament which present in the all bones, those who are located in a standing position, vertical position. Means जब दो bones आपस में एक दूसरे से जुड़ेंगे और उनका position vertical side में होगा तो उस पर lateral side से भी medial side से भी एक joint ligament होगा जो कि एक का distal extremity दूसरा का proximal extremity से जुड़ेगा, उसको हम लोग collateral ligament कहेंगे. अगर वो lateral side का होगा तो lateral collateral ligament और medial side का होगा तो medial collateral ligament. So this collateral ligament lateral and medial ligament extending from the distal end of tibia above and on both side, maybe lateral or medial side, and attached to the tarsal and large metatarsal below. Those located on lateral side, that is called the lateral collateral ligament. Those located on medial side, that is the medial collateral ligament. So this is clear. Next is posterior ligament. Posterior ligament, we will see the picture later on. This is clear. On this posterior lateral aspect, posterior border of tubercalosis. So now question is, sir, what is tubercalosis? Because you have not detailed idea about the each and every bones of this joint. So tubercalosis, we will say, show you, passes downward and is attached to the central plus fourth tarsal bones and to the large metatarsal also. So right now we have discussed three main ligament, capsular ligament, you know, anterior and posterior, collateral, lateral side and medial side, and posterior. So come this picture, this is clear. First, we have already discussed the anterior ligament. So this is the anterior ligament, this one. This is the tibia bone. You see, this is the tibia and this is the tarsal. So anterior, and this is in the oblique manner, somewhat. So this is the anterior ligament, anterior capsular ligament, and behind this another ligament will posterior capsular ligament. Next, lateral collateral. This is the lateral part and it located superficially, so this is known as lateral collateral ligament. And behind this, towards the medial aspect, under below the medial collateral ligament. Okay, so two ligament clear: capsular, lateral collateral. Another was the posterior ligament. We have already this posterior. So it's posterior extend from the tubercalosis up to the central fourth and large metatarsal. So you see here, this is the tubercalosis. This is the tubercalosis of fibular tarsal. This extend from hair ligament and runs downward and forward in directions. Reaches up to the central plus fourth. This is the central plus fourth, and this is the tibial tarsal. And which, ये कौन सा tarsal होगा रोहित जो cursor move कर रहा?
ये sir fibular tarsal.
Right, fibular tarsal का distal part है sir. This is the distal part of the fibular tarsal. So it extends from the tubercalosis, runs downward and forward in direction, crosses the central plus fourth and metatarsal. This is the metatarsal na. So this is the posterior ligament. So out of six ligament, three ligament had clear: anterior capsular, posterior capsular, lateral collateral, lateral medial, and posterior ligament. Okay. So next will the dorsal oblique ligament, and last is tarsal metatarsal ligament. So dorsal oblique is the narrow band like ligament which extend from the anterior aspect of the joint. In this picture, we will dorsal oblique ligament. Dorsal. This is the dorsal surface. This is not showing dorsal oblique like this one. This is the anterior oblique hai, and this anterior oblique like the dorsally in not a straight manner like this manner. Again, this ligament involved from this tibia bones up to the metatarsal, and this is known as dorsal oblique ligament. And this ligament extend from the medial side of tibial tarsal, passes obliquely downward and attached with the central fused fourth as well also with the large metatarsal. So this is the dorsal oblique. And tarsal metatarsal ligament on its plantar aspect. Plantars means posterior. You must know about what is plantar and palmar. palmar comes under the forelimb, plantars comes under the hindlimb. So the joint, it bended in the form of the plantar oblique manner and adherent to the all tarsal nerve. Like the dorsal oblique, it located anterior side, and this is located posterior side, and which attached through the all tarsal bone along with the ulna metatarsal bone. It also bended medially with the medial collateral ligament. It comes in contact with the medial collateral ligament also, and laterally with the plantar tarsal ligament, and its plantar face is lanced by a synovial membrane which forms a sheath that is known as tarsal sheath. So you also studied about that sheath, carpal sheath in the forelimb, which is formed by the involvement of distal extremity of humerus, carpal and the metacarpal. Likewise, that here also formation of the sheath, that is tarsal sheath, involvement of the tibial tarsal distal extremity, tarsal bone, as well as the proximal extremity of metatarsal. And we will later on discuss what is the in detail tarsal sheath. So we have completed 5 ligament out of 6 here, common ligament 6. We have completed capsular, in between 2 articulating, anterior and posterior, collateral, lateral and medial, posterior from pure calcis through the center plus 4 and up to the metatarsal, but it's located in posterior side. Next, tarsal metatarsal. Name indicate tarso metatarsal means it ligaments, that ligaments comes in contact with tarsal as well as metatarsal. But we are discussing about the tibio-tarsal articulation, means also having and connection with the tibia bone, distal extremity of tibia bone, and mainly present on behind, behind means plantar region, palmar region. Plantar region is formed by the posterior surface of metatarsals up to the last digit. This is the plantar. बच्चा जब चलता है, हम लोगों का प्लांटर जैसे खड़ा होते हैं तो देखते हो, पैर जब रखते हैं तो ग्राउंड के टच में कौन कौन सा बोन आता है, कौन कौन सा बोन आ रहा है? टिबिया फिबुला तो नहीं आ रहा है, टार्सल आ रहा है, कुछ पार्ट टार्सल का आ रहा है ना, उसके बाद मेटाटार्सल आ रहा है और डिजिट आ रहा है, उसी को प्लांटर बोलते हैं। हथेली हमारा है, आपका भी हथेली है, तो हथेली को पाल्मर सरफेस बोलते हैं, पाम। इस पाम को बनने में कौन कौन सा बोन का इन्वॉल्वमेंट होता है? मेटाकार्पल है, कुछ हद तक कार्पल भी आता है, मेटाकार्पल आता है और डिजिट आता है। वही कह रहा है कि जो टार्सो मेटाटार्सल लिगामेंट्स है, ये प्लांटर एस्पेक्ट ऑफ जॉइंट पीछे की तरफ रहेगा, एंड इट इज ब्लेंडेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ प्लांटर ऑब्लिक मैनर में रहेगा, जो कि कैप्सुलर लिगामेंट पढ़े थे वहां से आता है और ऑल टार्सल बोन को टच करता है और फाइनली मेटाटार्सल के बीच जाकर समाहित हो जाता है। तो दिस इज नोन एज टार्सो मेटाटार्सल लिगामेंट। सो आउट ऑफ 5 वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द, और 6 वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द 5 लिगामेंट, एंड लास्ट लिगामेंट इज नोन एज एनुलर ring shaped ligament present in between tibia of its distal extremity as well as in tarsal. So this is known as annular ligament. So beside this ligament, it contains also a ring shaped ligament that is known as annular ligament, which serves to bind the tendon of muscle. Jo bhi wahan se muscles jaate hain, jiska jo tendinous part hota hai, usko bandhne ka kaaj karta hai. On the dorsal aspect, there are 2 proximal and distal, means total 3 ligaments present on dorsal side, and another is present on plantar side, means posterior side. So this is proximal annular ring stem ligament present on the dorsal aspect of this joint. This is large and thick. Another proximal extremity and proximal part and distal part. आगे की तरफ 2 ligament, एक ऊपर को एक नीचे के, पीछे की तरफ 1 ligament, this is the plantar or posterior ligament. पहले हम ये समझेंगे कि सर ये जो annular ligament होता है आगे की तरफ होता है और पीछे की तरफ होता है, तो जो आगे की तरफ होता है उसके 2 parts होते हैं, एक ऊपर की तरफ होता है एक नीचे की तरफ, means पहला एक प्रोक्सिमल रो के पास होता है, दूसरा डिस्टल रो के पास होता है। इन दोनों के बारे में बताया है कि जो ऊपर की तरफ होता है वो लार्ज होता है, थिक होता है, आगे वाला जो नीचे की तरफ होता है वो थिन होता है। कहां से कहां रहता है? रनिंग क्रॉसेस फ्रॉम द लैटरल मैल्यूलस। अब आपको आइडिया होगा कि सर लैटरल मैल्यूलस किसको बोला गया था, टीबिया का नीचे का पार्ट जो कि ट्यूरस स्ट्रक्चर था, लैटरल साइड में भी और मीडियल साइड में, जो लैटरल साइड में था उसको लैटरल मैल्यूलस कहा गया, जो मीडियल साइड में था उसको मीडियल मेल्युलस कहा गया। तो ये जो होता है ऊपर की तरफ है, मीन्स टिबिया बोन्स के पास है, पहला रो है, लार्ज एंड थिक रनिंग मीडियल टू द लेटरल मेल्युलस, इट बाइंड फेसेस डाउन एंड टेंडन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स। क्योंकि मैं पहले ही बता चुका हूँ कि एनुलर लिगामेंट का काम है कि जितने भी टेंडेंस वहां से गुजरते हैं, टेंडन व्हाट इज टेंडन, इज द पार्ट ऑफ मसल्स व्हिच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फाइबरस कॉर्ड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, उसको यहाँ पर बांधने का कार्य करता है। तो प्रोक्सिमल रो का जो एनुलर लिगामेंट होता है लेटरल मेल्युलस से कॉम्प्लेक्स मसल्स के टेंडन को बांधने का कार्य करता है। डिस्टल रो पतला होता है, इट अराइजेस फ्रॉम फिब्युलर टार्सल एंड रन्स ऑब्लिकली डाउनवर्ड मैनर अटैच्ड टू द लार्ज मेटाटार्सल। क्लियर हो गया कि सर आपने आगे की तरफ जो एनुलर लिगामेंट बताया उसकी संख्याएं दो है, एक ऊपर की तरफ एक नीचे की तरफ। ऊपर की तरफ जो है लेटरल मेल्युलस से निकलता है और कॉम्प्लेक्स मसल्स के टेंडन को पकड़ता है, दूसरा जो नीचे की तरफ है लेकिन वो भी आगे की तरफ है, वो फिब्युलर टार्सल से निकलता है और डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन में ऑब्लिक मैनर में चलता है और फाइनली वो लार्ज मेटाटार्सल को जाकर के जोड़ने का कार्य करता है। तो दिस इज द डिस्टल एनुलर लिगामेंट। सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द एंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ एनुलर लिगामेंट, अनदर इज द पोस्टीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द एनुलर लिगामेंट। सो दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन द प्लांटर लिगामेंट बिकॉज लोकेटेड ऑन द प्लांटर सरफेस, इट एक्सटेंड फ्रॉम द फिब्युलर टार्सल एंड प्लांटर लिगामेंट टू द मीडियल कोलेटरल लिगामेंट एंड दिस फॉर्म द पोस्टीरियर वॉल ऑफ टार्सल शीथ। जो नीचे की तरफ पूरे संरचनाएं बनती है टार्सल शीथ, उसका एक पीछे का भाग को बनाने का कार्य करता है। सो आई थिंक अप टू द सिक्स लिगामेंट वन इन योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस इज द कॉम्प्लेक्स, बट दिट इज सिंपल सिंपल एनुलर लिगामेंट। सर एनुलर लिगामेंट दो होते हैं, एक आगे की तरफ एक पीछे की तरफ। आगे वाला का दो पार्ट्स होता है सर, एक ऊपर की तरफ एक नीचे की तरफ। जो ऊपर की तरफ होता है उसको हम लोग प्रोक्सिमल एनुलर लिगामेंट कहते हैं और नीचे वाले को डिस्टल एनुलर लिगामेंट कहते हैं। तो ऊपर वाला थिक होता है, लार्ज होता है, नीचे वाला थिन होता है, और ऊपर का वाला जो होता है वो लेटरल मेल्युलस से कॉम्प्लेक्स मसल्स को बांधने का काम करता है, और नीचे वाला जो होता है फिब्युलर टार्सल से निकलता है और मेटाटार्सल को समाहित हो जाता है। दूसरा जो था प्लांटर अपोजिटेरियर एनुलर लिगामेंट, जो पीछे की तरफ ही है प्लांटर सरफेस में, और जो अपने टार्सल सिस्ट का